let go. So I'm back out again, guys, shooting another POV. It's just started to rain. I've actually today got the Sigma 30mm. In my last video, I said I wish I hadn't sold it. So I've gone and bought it again, picked it up, good secondhand bargain. Today is market day here in my local town, so hopefully we're gonna get some great street shots. We're gonna get some nice transaction shots. I'm gonna be handing over some money, people looking at stuff. Good storytelling street shots with a Sigma 30mm. Let's go get it. All right, so let's start right at the bottom, or top if you like, depending on which way you wanna call it. But yeah. Straight in, guy on the phone. So you just gotta get used to your focal length. So we're at 30mm here, or a 45mm full frame equivalent. So as you can see from that photo, I'm probably really need to be zoomed in. But look, his face is absolutely pin sharp. And I hate that word. I hate that pin sharp. So yeah, if you let me know in the comments, anyone got another word that they use for sharp photos, not pin sharp, because I sort of hate using that word. Anyway, might have missed some photo opportunities, gassing. Carry on. Now, guy on the phone with an umbrella. If that isn't a great shot I've ever seen, I don't know what is. Let's try and frame him up nicely. Focus on that umbrella. Beautiful. Yeah, lovely. Keeping most shots probably wide open at sort of 1.4. Also, probably looking to, let me step a few shots down. Oh yeah, this looks interesting. Look, these guys and girls choosing. Maybe come around to the front, get that shot. She's intrigued, look, he's intrigued. Focus on the guy. So when you can see there, a shot where they're obviously in conversation about buying some garments. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. I think it's going to start raining again, so that's not so perfect. But the thing is, you've got to almost kind of always be ready for the action, but not. So what's going on down here? Guy on his phone. Trust. Subject separation. That guy looked really moody. They're packing up because it's raining. Right, you can't blame them really. It's sort of been on and off rain all day, terrible. You know, I came and I walked the dogs earlier, it was a little bit busier than this, so it's kind of a shame because it was busier and now it's a bit dead, which is annoying. Touching up a jewellery. Here's action. Yes, yes, yes. Money, money, money. Did we get that? I might have been a little bit too far out. Oh, I was slightly too quick. You see, this is the first time I've been back on with the 30mm. And I have to be honest, I thought you'd get away with being a little bit further away than you are, which is not ideal. Yeah, that's a great shot. And that one. That's why I like people looking like they're doing something, a bit of interaction. It's good. Yeah, like I say, you do have to get quite close with this 30mm, which is something I'm not necessarily keen on. Yeah, guy with a pocket two look. Lovely. Just try and frame that woman up. We're on the post. Yeah, sort of. You know, I think the 85mm may suit me a little bit better than this guy does. Frame up the dog treats. No, I don't want that tracking. Focus on what I want you to focus on. Yes. Oh, a little bit too wet on that background, but not bad. You know, this is what lens is, 52mm thread. I've got a polarizer of 52mm. That's annoying. And I haven't got the, so some action shots here. There's some shots here all day. Go on this pole. Beautiful, he's even looking at me. Even better. Well, the range just started to come back down, so hopefully some good shots now. Yeah, here's some boys here looking at the garments. That was a great shot. So I mean, it just tells the story. He's looking at clothes. He's looking to buy some clothes. Perfect. Let's frame up this woman behind the van. Yes. Using that depth, using that 1.4 to blur out that van. Let's get that woman in shot. This guy here. He's looking in the shop window, he's interested. He's probably not going to buy anything because it's really overpriced in there. Yeah, get the usual looks of people like, what is that idiot doing? But what he's doing is, he's out having a great time with his camera, talking to himself. Perfect. What's going on down here? Whoa, get in, we've got some ambient light here as well. Yes. Oh, I'm loving it. You know, those lights across the top. Cute doggy. Everyone loves dogs, don't they? Who doesn't like dogs? She's on her phone there. Perfect. Yes. On the phone, action, action. Those guys there. Yeah, this is what it's all about. Rainy, wintry street photography, perfect. Loving it. Absolutely loving it. With this guy talking at the batch fan. We've definitely got one here. Oh, yes. Even better. Lovely.
Is it on the car park?
Well, can be. Just taking a photo, what do you reckon?
What's that for then?
Just taking street photos. Photographer.
We want to get this fan moved, mate. It's blocking the road.
No, because you can use it. You see, I used it as a leading line to photograph down here.
You're trying to take money, yeah?
Oh, yeah, it's really starting to rain now. So this is when I maybe get my best shots. Oh, this woman looks, she wants some chips. Oh, no one wants a photo taken, though, do they? Right. Yeah, you? Good, good. I know him from somewhere, but I'm not sure where. Right, let's get a few more shots and then I think even I'll hit the hay then. It's a good job this A6400 is weather sealed, eh? Not sure about the lens though, so I'll just hold it down, look. Imagine that. Imagine the camera wasn't weather sealed, how annoying would that be? Yeah, get in there. I'm pretty wet now. One thing though, I don't know if the microphone's waterproof. So, yeah, that's interesting. Let's see. Oh, I'm going this doorway. So I've just about dried off. I don't know if you saw right at the end there, I was getting a little bit worried because the screen just wasn't turning on, wasn't working. Don't know what was going on, but literally as soon as I walked back home, I put it in my bag, dried the screen off, dried the camera off a bit. As soon as I turned the camera on, the screen worked. So I don't know what that was about, whether there's some feature that's built into it. But yeah, this guy, the 30mm Sigma, you know, I think this is just a fantastic lens that if you're on APS-C, if you're looking at your first prime lens or adding to the prime lenses you've got, this is the do it all really. You know, I've left a review before on it and I criticized it a bit against
the other Sigmas, the 16 and the 56, in saying that it's in autofocus performance and a few of the things, it's actually the worst lens. And I still agree with that. You know, it was the first released in the collection and they just improved on it. But it's still a fantastic lens of an amazing trio, I guess. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please give it a thumbs up if you liked it. I mean, I got soaked, so it deserves a thumbs up for that, surely. Subscribe to the channel. I'll catch you in the next one, guys.